Welcome back to Lucky Tech. Today I'm gonna review this budget gaming laptop Colorful P15 with RTX 4050. This laptop only cost about 700 bucks in my country. Well, in some country with lower tax rate, it could be cheaper. The processor is using the Core i5 12th Gen 12450H. That Core i5 version is different than 12500H. 12500H have 8 E-cores and 12450H only have 4 E-cores. So this laptop only have 4 P-core and 4 E-core. Let's see what we get inside the packaging when we buy this laptop. Opening this laptop is quite tricky. You need to unscrew all the screw below first. Then you need to open the hinge cover. And then unscrew the screw beneath the hinge. There are two NVMe heatsink attached in the bottom cover. Out of the box, you will only get one DDR5 16GB RAM with 5600MHz speed. Plus is you can just buy one more 16GB to get 32GB config, and the minus is you will not get dual channel out of the box. The installed SSD doesn't have any thermal pad to conduct the heat to the heatsink. So this is the original spec: i5-12450H, 16GB 5600 with single channel only, 500GB NVMe Gen 3 and RTX 4050. Don't forget it already have 100% sRGB screen. I upgrade the laptop with extra 16GB of RAM. Single channel is not good for gaming. Since it has dual NVMe slot, I can just install second NVMe easily. For content creator, having second NVMe is very good. If your SSD run off terabyte write, your primary system will not affected. I also install ThermalPad for the NVMe. ThermalPad is cheap, but I'm not sure why they don't install it out of the box. The heatsink become useless because the heat is not conducted. With only 700 bucks, you already get very nice screen. It has 100% sRGB, 144Hz refresh rate. Other budget laptop only provide you with about 64-65 sRGB or 45% NTSC, while this laptop already provide you with 72% NTSC or 99-100% sRGB. You can adjust your fan and power profile in control center. There are also menu to enable and disable camera and touchpad. You also already get the RGB keyboard with macro. You can change the keyboard RGB with the control center. However, you can only apply one color at same time, and there is no styling in the keyboard light up. You can only adjust the sleep timer from the keyboard backlight. The battery life of this laptop is only about 2 hours 20 minutes with entertainment mode noiseless setting and 50% brightness. As you can see, the CPU consume a little bit watt, but the total system power consume about 23-26 watts. The included NVMe is pretty good. It's only NVMe Gen 3, but the speed is expected. This is how the camera looks like and how the microphone sound. Well, the camera looks so crappy. It's only 720p 30fps camera with low quality pixel. You cannot expect more from a budget gaming laptop. Now let's test the fan noise and CPU performance. In Cinebench R23, entertainment score about 9K, performance about 10K, and quiet about 3.9K. Performance mode is not effective, it's louder, more heat, and the performance increment only a little. Default and noiseless entertainment mode is about the same. However, I noticed that the temperature actually is not supposed to be in a gaming laptop with dual fan. With this cooling, the temperature actually should be better. I noticed that the CPU has too much thermal paste. The middle area is not covered by thermal paste because it not spread equally. I cleaned the thermal paste and used Noctua NTH2 because this one is the best thermal paste for laptop. Just need to apply a little in the middle area because the pressure will make it spread equally. and when the chip heat up, the middle area will not dry out. After I test again, the temperature difference is quite significant. It's about 8 to 7 degrees Celsius different. This temperature is what should be expected out of the box. Let's go to gaming performance. I use entertainment noiseless setting to run the benchmark. The first game is Wukong. At high setting with DLSS 65%, you can expect almost 60fps average without frame generation. And if you using the frame generation, you can get about 83fps. Next game is Hogwarts Legacy with DLSS quality at ultra setting. Without frame generation, you can almost get 60fps, and with frame generation, you can get about 91fps. And the last game I test here is Resident Evil 4. At native setting, you can get almost 60fps with high texture 2GB and other setting at high. And if you turn on FSR2 quality, you can get about 74fps. For 700 bucks, you already get a laptop with very nice screen and including RTX 4050. If you buying other brand laptop, you will only get RTX 3050 6GB version and maybe with 45% NTSC screen, which is worse than this one. Performance difference between 3050 and 4050 is very big. The other plus of this laptop, it also have 2 NVMe slot and upgradable RAM. Mostly for about the same budget, you only get the laptop with 1 NVMe slot, example MSI Thin or MSI Cyborg. With 2 NVMe slot, especially if you are a content creator, it will consume a lot of terabyte write in your SSD. So, in case something happen with your other SSD, your primary system will still okay. The keyboard also feel nice. However, I don't like the numpad. It's not comfortable for typing. But maybe different for some other people. Maybe they like the laptop with numpad. The thermal management for this laptop is also good. I usually use the noiseless mode to reduce the noise significantly. The temperature still acceptable with noiseless mode. If you want drop even more, you can always disable the noiseless mode, but it will cause the louder fan noise. Okay, now let's talk about what I don't like from this laptop. The first one, of course, is heavy. Because usually, I always bring laptop for about 1.5 to 1.7 kilogram. But for some people, maybe it's normal. The second is the camera quality. Well, what you expect for a budget gaming laptop? They will just put a potato webcam. Another thing is touchpad. The responsibility of the touchpad is not very good. Well, it's a budget gaming laptop. They not design the touchpad to be used for anything because mostly you will use mouse for gaming. But if you want to do something like office work or video editing and you only want to use the touchpad, you lazy to bring your mouse, it's not feel very nice. And the other thing is the quality control. I'm not sure why my unit have very bad thermal paste application. It makes my CPU run very hot out of the box. I don't know if it's apply for all batch of this laptop or only my unit. After I apply the thermal paste myself, it reduced about 7 degrees Celsius, which is very high. Well, you really need to be careful when you want to change thermal paste for this laptop. Don't break the seal. You need to open the seal very carefully to not break the warranty seal, because it might be void your warranty. For someone who never checked the temperature per watt for each laptop they use, they will not notice this problem. But I already test a lot of laptop, and I know at what temperature that this laptop should be operate at certain TDP. So overall, for 700 bucks including the tax, this laptop is really worth. However, it might be not for all the normal people. If you doesn't know how to change the thermal paste for this laptop, I don't think this laptop is for you. But for someone who can apply the thermal paste by themselves, this laptop is very good. I'm not sure is my laptop defective or not, but if you want to go safety, I think you can choose another option like MSI Thin, MSI Cyborg, or maybe the Lenovo Legion, which is already have a good thermal management out of the box. Okay, that's all from me. If you like this video, please press like and subscribe. And don't forget to check the link in the description below. Thanks for watching.